That's all she wanted, was a place of her own. And she finally got it. And one of the kids was sick. I don't know if it was Marty, I don't know if it was Maureen, but they had to go to the doctors with the sibling almost every other day. So my grandmother more or less took over me. Actually, I was like her son. That's how often I was over there. But when you walked into that little house, it was so quiet and so peaceful, you know. You just, you know, I remember crying because Ma and Dad were going and they were taking Marty to the hospital. And I wasn't going, and blah, blah, blah. As soon as I got to Grandma's house, all that stopped, you know, because how calm it was in that house. And then, you know, she started talking about the baseball announcer for the Cubs. What the heck was his name? Before Harry Carey.
Brickhouse.
Before Brickhouse.
Oh, wow. Before. I don't even know that one. Yeah.
But anyway, besides that, he's so kind. Yeah, she used to make me braid her hair. It took hours and hours.
To keep you off that tower.